The workup's in the cabinet's hands. They said they'll call for us once they've gotten to properly review it. But listen, I know I should have been more forthcoming about who I was earlier. So, in the interest of full disclosure, there's one more thing you ought to know before we head up there. My relationship with the UC, it's more complicated than it might seem at first glance. The UC's actually the only reason I'm here in the first place. I am a clone of a man named Francois Sanon, one-time fleet admiral of the UC during the Colony War, former head of the UC Navy. They called him Ve Victis, woe to the defeated, in Old Earth Latin, a title he earned. The program I was a part of, it was the UC's attempt to create a new generation of military minds from one of their most respected tacticians. Secure the leadership of the UC military for generations to come. I'm getting there. The man I was cloned from, my father, was executed for acts he committed during the war. The man caused a lot of death on both sides. Freestar Collective and UC. Military and civilians. And the things he did, well, they're a part of the reason the UC and Freestar Collective aren't really on great terms to this day. So my involvement, it could be another obstacle they throw at us up there. I just wanted you to be forewarned. I really appreciate you saying that. I just thought you deserved to know, considering how much you've done already. You know, while we've got a second, was there anything else we needed to discuss? I know you got dropped into the middle of this pretty fast. Or if you've got any last-minute business to attend to, now might be a good time. No telling how long the cabinet's gonna keep us waiting out here. Then I guess it's just a matter of...
The cabinet meeting is about to begin. All parties, please proceed to the cabinet chambers.
Sounds like our cue.
Captain,
can I help you?
Ah, welcome. You must be the Captain Hadrian mentioned in her report. You have our thanks for the risks you faced in securing this information.
Oh, I'm sure she did.
Yes, well, precisely how urgent is what I hope we'll determine here today. So now, we have two petitioners here making a surprising request. Access to the UC Xenowarfare team's Terramorph data, currently housed in the Armistice Archives. A request which will require not just this body's agreement, but that of all three Armistice signatories. UC, Freestar Collective, and House Varun. Now, Captain, we've all read Hadrian's report on the subject, but we have yet to hear from you. Perhaps you could summarize for the Cabinet what it is you see as the goal of this endeavor. That is something to consider. Though we also have to take into account the nature of the data you require.
Madam President, I object to the very premise of this meeting. While no one would argue that what happened on Tau Ceti was anything less than a tragedy, Terramorph attacks are not some sudden new threat on the horizon. They've been happening for generations. To demand we hand over banned archival knowledge and possibly upset the balance of galactic diplomacy because of a single attack seems at best panic. And at worst, a power grab by the daughter of a bloodthirsty warmonger and her associates.
I would remind the chief diplomat who he's speaking to. If it's my father you're looking to address, you're welcome to consult a medium. I would also ask, how many deaths the cabinet requires to act. 50? 50,000? Because if tragedies like Tau Ceti are just prelude to more attacks, I have no doubt you'll get the body count you require.
Let's keep this civil, shall we? And while there should be no doubt, the preservation of life stands paramount among this body's duties. Chief Essien has a point. Will a single attack, however troubling, be sufficient to convince the other factions to grant us access to what they no doubt consider weapon data?
I don't think it's enough.
Perhaps you can help, Captain. As the one who actually collected the sample in question, did this Terramorph seem at all alarming to you?
That is worth considering. This attack took place on an almost completely uninhabited world. The casualties were minimal as a result. But if there's another attack, will we be so lucky?
Yes, a fine point, Admiral. So then, Captain, given the discussion now and the information you've been privy to thus far, if you were in our position, would you grant the request made to open the archives?
If the stakes weren't so high, we wouldn't be asking. But, well, we're asking.
I'm inclined to agree.
As am I. I suppose that does get to the heart of the point, doesn't it? Very well. I consent. The galaxy was lucky you were here today, Captain.
You and I are in agreement, Chief Diplomat. So, if there are no other objections, I believe we can agree to give our full backing to make the request to... What was that? Incident. Chief Sarkin, what's happening?
There's been an attack at the spaceport. Terramorphs.
Terramorphs? More attacks. Just as predicted.
Good God. There must be another explanation. The creatures evaded our scanner somehow.
There will be plenty of time for conjecture later. Chief Sarkin, order the evacuation of the spaceport and have your men contain the things, but do it discreetly. The last thing we need is a citywide panic.
Yes, ma'am.
Admiral Logan, the local barracks can provide support.
I'll make the order myself. Nearest anti-Xeno squad, though, is off-world. Going to take a while to bring them in.
Well then, we'll have to make do with the tools we've got. You two, you can't risk those things getting out of the spaceport. I want you both on the next train there. We'll let them know you're coming and that you've dealt with these things before. Now go show them how it's done.
We're on it, ma'am. Captain, I'm right behind you. Let's get down there.
chance.
Got here when you did. I just wish it hadn't come to that.
Yeah, what the hell happened back there, Captain? There's no excuse for using lethal force here. Sorry doesn't bring these people back. A crisis isn't licensed to cast aside your morals. Understand? Now, officer, the way those people were acting, I've seen this before. They were under the Terramorph's influence, weren't they?
I don't know. They were down at the port and they just started screaming. We tried to restrain them, get them on the train to get them out of harm's way, but some of the other officers down there, we couldn't restrain them fast enough. They just started firing on us. People we knew. They went berserk.
Pheromonic projection. Some Terramorphs, they can induce this fog. It affects everyone differently, but some people just lose control, turn against everyone around them, even if they don't want to. They're like a puppet. You kill the Morph, you break the hold. But this means we're gonna need to be real careful with our fire and keep that EM weapon at the ready. Let's do it.
That's unlocked. Please, do what you can to help them.
Butts. We We've got the remaining creatures locked down on the landing pad, but we're barely holding our perimeter. They said you've done this before. Well, one fire team to spare and whatever supplies you need, but I can't risk them taking over any more of my men. Do it fast. We'll hold them as best we can.
You might be looking for some backup. You say the word, we're out there on your six.
You two have any experience with Terramorphs before?
Only the brief they just gave on the way here. But we know how to handle pressure.
Surviving a full-on mental assault isn't the same as keeping your cool in a firefight. Might make you more liability than asset.
We're not UC security. You don't need to worry about us. Roger that. We're on you. Take us on. Bring it.
I wonder what Jacob would think of a crow helping to save New Atlantis. Damn if I'm not proud of it, though.
I've got some stuff on my mind. When you have the time.
People weren't so lucky.
The few protecting the many.
And it would have been plenty more if it hadn't been for the two of you. The city owes you both a debt after this.
We were just in the right place at the right time. Captain, we should report back to the President. Let her know the Terramorphs have been dealt with. Take care of yourself, Sergeant.
Thank you, gentlemen. Let your people all know how much we owe them today.
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, there you are. I believe we have some things we should discuss.
The next time Terramorphs rear their ugly heads, the UC is going to be ready.
Captain? Hadrian? It would appear that the Cabinet owes you our thanks for what you did for the city today. As well as an apology. Your concerns about the Terramorphs, well, consider them validated.
Thank you, ma'am.
Of course. I only wish we could have acted sooner. Now, today's events have only clarified our path forward in the eyes of the Cabinet. You will have our full support in collecting the Terramorph data from the archives, as well as a subsequent investigation into the nature of these attacks. But to accomplish those goals, we're going to need the right people in the right places. As such, the Cabinet has authorized me to reinstate you, Hadrian, effective immediately, to your former rank of Major. As soon as we've got the data in hand, we want you investigating these attacks and how to stop them. Will you do this?
Yes. Yes, ma'am. I'd be honored.
Excellent. But as you've both made clear, for such an investigation to succeed first, we're going to need someone to convince the Free Star Collective and House Varun to play ball. Someone who knows precisely the sorts of dangers the colonies and all the galaxy are facing right now. The Cabinet wants you, Captain, to be that representative. We do. In exchange, we're willing to fast-track your citizenship upon collection of the data. So, will you help us? I'm glad to hear it. Now, we, of course, won't be sending you in without the proper support. Deputy McIntyre in the Office of Interstellar Affairs will be your guide on gaining access to the archives. You should be able to find her in her office across the hall. And on behalf of the whole of the United Colonies, you have our thanks. We're dismissed.
Damage to the spaceport. The costs of this attack are greater than I think we realize.
I'm gonna go check in with Chief Engineer Kulkarni.